Hi guys, I'm Randy, and today on BRS TV, we're exploring a variety of TDS meters from HM Digital and Hanna Instruments to get a more accurate view of the contaminant levels in the water you use for your tank. Today we'll talk about what a TDS meter can do for you, which one to choose, and how to get them installed on your RODI unit. Since nearly every water source is chemically different than another and could contain contaminants and elements that we just don't want in our reef tanks, there's really no way of knowing with 100% certainty what's actually in our tap water without some pretty hefty and often expensive testing equipment. However, with a TDS meter, which reads the electrical conductivity of those most common contaminants we want to eliminate, we can get a pretty good idea of how pristine our water is before we use it in our tanks. Although we do have color-changing DI resin, which provides a decent representation of TDS being filtered out, without a TDS meter, we're sort of blindly hoping that our filters are working as efficiently as possible. With a meter installed, we can not only monitor the effectiveness and lifespan of our RO membrane, but we can also identify when TDS is bypassing the final DI resin stages, which may occur when the resin is exhausted, or even if the resin isn't packed tightly enough and that high TDS water follows a channel into your product water. Let's talk about how many TDS probes you may need for your RODI unit. If you own a unit that doesn't have TDS meters already installed, there are a couple options that have you testing your water's TDS in no time. Each TDS meter takes less than a minute to install and come in 1, 2, or 3 probes. However, if you didn't want to install one inline, you could pick up one of these handheld TDS testing pins, like this one from HM Digital. Outside of that, if you're looking for a more permanent, quick, and easy solution, where all you have to do is simply look at your water's TDS as it passes through the various stages of your RODI unit, picking up one of these inline options may be the best way to go. With that in mind, TDS is really only filtered out of the water through the RO membrane and the DI resin stage, so it's most important to install one TDS meter probe after each of these two stages, and is why a dual TDS meter is most popular and generally what we recommend. With a TDS sensor installed directly after the RO membrane, you can determine a baseline of what TDS level to expect when your membrane is functioning properly, and as the membrane's effectiveness depletes over time, you'll be able to monitor it through the increase of TDS getting through, which will serve as an indication to change the membrane. Since oftentimes there is residual TDS that the RO membrane can't reject out of the water source, adding a TDS sensor after the DI resin will also help to make sure that none is making it to your water change water or your top-off water. If you're only going to use a single probe TDS meter, measuring after the DI resin is the critical point because it's measuring the quality of water you're going to be putting in the reef tank. Finally, since the sediment filters and carbon blocks don't necessarily remove TDS directly, there's not much need for a meter between them, but as an option, you could add an additional TDS probe before the entire RODI unit to get an idea of what the TDS is coming directly from your tap. One thing to note here, the TDS from your tap is not likely to change significantly, so it's not the most common place to add a sensor. For assembly, I'll first want to install the sensors themselves into the included push connect fittings. Here, it's very important that the conductivity probes on the sensor tip are oriented so that the water passes over them equally. The easiest way to know that they're installed correctly is by looking through the fitting for the probes to be side by side. If you don't clearly see two probe ends, simply rotate the sensor until they are in place. Installation of the sensors couldn't be easier and really only takes a couple of steps. Today we're installing a TDS meter in the most common configuration, which is on the blue product water line after the RO membrane and after the DI resin stage. We'll use the dual TDS sensor and start by installing the probe labeled in anywhere on the blue tubing directly after the membrane. In order to do that, I'll make a clean 90 degree cut on the line using my tube clippers, then simply insert the ends of the tube into the T fitting and I'm done. To install the other sensor, just make the same clean 90 degree cut on the blue product water line after the DI resin and push the tubing into either end of the T fitting. Alternatively, if you wanted to run that triple TDS meter and know the TDS of your home's water, make that same clean cut on the product feed water line going into the first stage of the RO system, and on the BRS systems, that is the red line. Then insert the ends of the tubes into the T fitting and you're done. For ongoing use, it's best practice to not run the DI resin completely past the exhaustion point and change out your DI resin when there's only a band of unchanged color about a half inch thick. The TDS meter you installed will help you to make sure that the resin is still producing zero TDS. As for the RO membrane, as I mentioned earlier, you'll be able to monitor the TDS output after the membrane and over the course of using the RODI unit, determine when it's time to replace the filter. There are a few maintenance steps that you can do on your TDS meter and probes to make sure that they're always reading as accurately as possible. Starting with the occasional cleaning of the probe tips with some rubbing alcohol and letting them air dry before placing them back into the fittings. Along with that, you may want to periodically check that the probes are installed correctly with the two probe tips side by side. Lastly, although the battery lasts for quite a long time, it doesn't last forever, and changing it out may be necessary down the road. Thanks for watching, and if you have any more questions that we didn't answer here, feel free to give us a call, send us an email, or hop on a chat. See you next time on BRS TV.